What is going on, guys, and welcome back to another footy card video. I have not been doing footy card videos in a couple of weeks now, and it is quite hard due to this COVID stage 4 restrictions. It's almost impossible now to get packs, but I recently thought of an idea which might be quite interesting. I have been collecting the Teamcoach cards for quite some time. The first ever packs that I've gotten were way back in 2006 when I was only 3 years old. So in this video, what I thought I'd like to do is go over my Teamcoach collection from over the years, starting at 2006 all the way to 2020. The video might be a little bit lengthy, but I think it might be quite enjoyable, especially for all you footy card fans. Alrighty, so before we get into the collection update, I just thought I'd like to show you quickly where I keep all my footy cards. So there are some empty boxes I've kept from over the years, and as you can see, these are albums from all over the years. I got Select in there as well. Got a few albums, and I got some more Teamcoach albums. I'm gonna go find the special albums, and then we'll go straight into the collection video. Alrighty, so I guess we might as well get in straight into the video. This will be a while, so my 2006 and 2007 Teamcoach cards are all flicked in here. I'll only go through these ones briefly. You can see the condition in these cards are very poor. I think these are just 2006 Teamcoach, so it's barely a collection. Look at that Brad Green card. It's damaged, it's destroyed. So yeah, that's pretty much all of 2006. So if I can get this in, that'd be nice. So that's literally all I've got, so barely anything. Nothing to see there for 2006. I was 5 when the 2008 cards came. I finally had a proper album for them, so briefly go through them. They're how the silvers look like. Just go through them pretty quickly, not too much to say. This card was kind of cool, although they are in pretty bad condition. Got a few silvers. I got a, there we go, Starwild Brendan Goddard. That's definitely the best hit of that season, but overall pretty average. The cards aren't in great condition either. So next up we have 2010. I've skipped 2007 and 2009 because they're in separate albums. So let's have a look at the 2010 cards. Anyway, so there are a few of the commons. I got a few silvers here and there. I don't want to go through all those commons, so I just flick through them, all that stuff, because we still got so many more years to cover. But these cards are all right. As you can see, I was like only 7. So the cards are in poor condition. I got a few golds. I got a best and fairest. I got a magic of St Kilda. As you can see, the golds are in pretty average condition. Got a couple more best and fairest, and I got 2 magics and a star, but they were basically bought off eBay. But yeah, some decent cards there. The magics were in glow, so that was also quite cool. Alrighty, so 2010. Moving on to 2011, I was 8 years old when I got these cards. And this is the first year that Teamcoach introduced this silver code, so as you can see, there's a Harry O'Brien silver code. They were 1 in 2 packs. The golds were 1 in every pack in this year. I'm just going to flick through them, see if there are any other cards in this set that... there are other cards in this set. I'm pretty sure they were best and fairest. I don't know if I've got any. I'm pretty sure I do. Yeah, I do. There's a Brent Harvey best and fairest. And then some checklists. And then these are the good cards. Mostly off eBay. But here we go, a few magics and stars. Nick Rail one was a nice one. So there's 2011 Teamcoach, and then we got moving on to 2012. This is when I started kind of collecting seriously this year, and this album's just filled with the special. So I sorted them in teams this year. We've got, what are the cards? You got a checklist, best and fairest. What other cards you got? These are captain cards, Wheat Bix captain cards. Those were cool. I feel like if they brought them back, I wouldn't be too disappointed. Just gonna flick through them, I guess. What else have we got? We've got another captain, St Kilda. We got a 3D best and fairest. They got a Stephen Milne magic, which is nice. The checklist and another Ryan Griffin magic. And then also, these are where I had my 2007 and 9 cards. I got a Daniel Kerr star and 3 wild cards here. And then, yeah, pretty just average condition because I was only a little kid. I didn't treat the cards with respect. Like, look at this Lance Whitnall card. I think golds in this year was like 1 in every 4, and I tore this one to shreds. So, as you can see, didn't treat the cards with a lot of respect. As we'll move on to 2013. Actually, you know what I'm going to do for starters? We're going to go quickly to the 2013 album, and we will show you the silvers. I know I won't go over the silvers for every year, but I got the complete set this year. This is the first year where I actually started trying, like, officially. I know 2012 I did try, but I also collected a lot of the select cards. But as you can see, full set of silvers. And these weren't the best silvers, but they were all just pretty good to get the whole set. I remember trading with my friends that year. I thought that was quite cool. And then this one, condition of the album's not in great shape, but it does the job. I almost tried to get the gold set. I was quite close to getting the gold set. Well, I mean, these were one in two packs. I got the whole of the premiership golds. They should bring them back, Team Coach. And these are the wild cards. Got a fair few. Like the wild cards. Got the gold checklists. I had the Richmond one. I just misplaced it. And then I got the footy pointers. These were a good hit. I loved the footy pointers. These were nice. Star stickers. Not a favourable card in the set. And then the best and fairest. I think this is their last year of the 3D best and fairests. Alright, as we move on to 2014, I'm not going to bother with the silvers. Don't want this video to go ages. So we'll just go over the real cool cards. These are the golds. I didn't collect these the 2014 cards too much. These were still 1 and 2. They had stripes in the back of the golds. I'll show you the premiership golds. They had the premiership in the back. Then we'll move on to the good ones. I didn't do nearly as good in 2014 as I did in 2013. I got these footy pointers. These are some nice cards. First year, the footy flixes. I like the footy flixes. Then they did these footy pal cards where you could scratch them off and it was quite easily to, you know, damage. A few silver checklists, didn't really have too many. And then 8 wild cards that year. I did some good stuff. Got the Magics, had a white background. Stars had a gold background. Alrighty, we're up to 2015. We're flying through these. These are just silvers and golds, so I might as well just go through them pretty quickly. I think these are one of my favourite years they had the golds. So yeah, silvers and golds. Pretty self-explanatory. These are what they look like. Pretty cool cards. And then we've got the, we'll go quickly to the 2015 inserts. I had the full set of the footy pals. I just misplaced it when I made my History of Team Coach video. Got a few prize cards. The footy pals, they were a lot better this year. The footy flixes, those are still in the set. They had the first set of the footy pop-ups, which I wasn't really a fan of. These ones are decent. The captain cards, quite plain though. And then these are the wild cards. I'm pretty sure I still have a Brandon Ellis wild card, but I got no clue where I put it. Next up, we've got the 2016 Team Coach album. I did all right this year. The footy pop-ups, these are my least favourite cards of probably any set. They were just too plain, basic, and common to get. And then the glows. I don't know why they added the glow variant. Got some captain cards here. We got the footy pals. And then the Herald Sun footy pals. So they had two sets of the footy pals, which is awesome. Some more footy flicks cards. And then I think that's it. Then we got some prize cards where they had them oval. Wasn't a fan, but still alright. And then the Magics and Stars. Love the Stars that year. One of my favourite years for the Stars. And the Magics also looked quite sick as well. So, yeah. I'm only going to show now the real inserts. I'm not going to bother with the silvers or golds. 2017. They had the footy pop-ups. They had A and B. So, they had like a kicking and a handballing variant. So, there we go. They're the pop-ups. Then we got the best and fairest. I like these ones. I liked how they had the players celebrating. So the close-up shot of them, I got the set of that. These were the glow footy powers. I thought they were all right. They could have been a little bit more creative with these cards. Some more footy powers. I did enjoy those cards. Some more footy flicks. And then, there's the Brandon Ellis Magic. I almost misplaced it. And then there's just a few select inserts as well, but we'll skip through those. And then these are the 2017 Magics, which were pretty cool, and Stars. But these were controversial, these Stars. They were sideways. I didn't like them that much. They had two wild cards in a box as well in 2017. So a different year, and the gold prize cards, which I thought were decent. But first year, though, I unboxed footy cards for the channel. So that's, that's something to go by. Alrighty, we only got 3 more years to go, 2018. I was opening footy cards in 2018 for the channel, so you guys are probably familiar with these cards. Battle teams, these are the first year they had the battle teams. I didn't mind them, but they were quite dull, quite boring. The footy flexes, they introduced different types of footy flexes, like marking, kicking. Then we got the best and fairest. I really like these cards, and I think I had the set as well. I just misplaced a couple of them. These are the footy powers. Also like the cards, really nice. Then we've got the footy flips. First year they had the footy flipses. Then they had these Herald Sun silver cards. Pretty cool, captain cards. And then the prize cards, these were sideways. I got a few of them. And then only the 5-star are magics, but these are the first year that they introduced the trophy Star Wilds, and I was lucky enough to get the one, Dustin Martin. Alrighty, so now we're up to 2019. This was last year. I did a few videos on the channel in 2019 for these cards. I almost had the set of the battle teams, but to be fair, they weren't my favorite cards. The footy powers, I liked them, got the set. Footy flipses, these were different. Just like this year's, you could actually properly flip him. And then we got the best and fairest. Kind of like them, similar to the 2018 ones. The new footy pods, you got a glow and a rub variant. And then we got the prize cards, which is similar to last year's. And then we got the captain cards, which were exclusive to Maccas. And then the star and magics. I got quite a few. But no trophies, unfortunately. But yeah, did like these cards. And now we are up to 2020. Now I've done an album update, a couple for this year, but I might as well just throw it into the video. These are the current cards. So yeah, I'll go quickly. You guys know how they are. Footy flips, they have the Rising Star, the galleries, the BNFs have the set. Fab Fives, new cards to the set. I do like them. The Battle Bods, they made a return. The glows and the glitters. We've got the 3D icons. I really do rate these ones as well. The mascots, one of my favorites. The players, also nice. And then the Maccas cards, which I thought were better than last year's. And then the prize cards. And then the star and magics. And yeah, I got a couple trophies, which is quite nice. But there we go. So I think we'll wrap it up there. We've got all the albums on the couch on my messy old bed. But I think you guys might enjoy this video. A bit of a different one, bit of a longer one, but I wanted to keep up with the footy card videos, and I thought, you know, making a whole collection update from when I first started, when I was 3 years old, to now, yeah, I thought that'd be quite interesting. And if you guys did enjoy the video, make sure to leave a like. If you want to see a part two for select cards, if this video gets 150 likes, I'll be doing a part two. But yeah, just appreciate the support I've been getting on the channel. Footy card videos will probably be now once a fortnight, and I'll see you guys very soon in my next video.